Coming up in this video, we say no to AA batteries and make my trackpad rechargeable. Apple A1339 Trackpad Lithium Ion Conversion. I got this trackpad in working order from a recycling centre for 50 cents. It's a handy device, much better on your wrist than a regular mouse. I highly recommend it. My only problem, it takes AA batteries. At $1.80 a pop for disposable energizers or $16 for rechargeable batteries plus a charger, the cost does add up. Today we'll fix that and make it rechargeable. This is the basic layout. I have an iPhone battery, it looks like a third party one. I think it's out of a 5 or a 5S. A TP4056 charge module and a DC converter. I'm choosing to connect it to the trackpad with a battery blank with terminals on each end. We won't be needing any of this, so let's expose the terminals. Making sure of the polarity. This is the final version of the battery blank. It's as long as two AAs with channels to run the wires down. Once printed, I soldered some wires to nickel strips, which I used for end terminals. I'm drilling a hole for the wires to go through. Note, this is the only irreversible step. Everything else can easily be removed to go back to AA's if something goes wrong. Handy little chuck for my impact driver. It won't take larger bits, but can save time if you're drilling a lot of pilot holes. Of course, I did need the drill for the final hole. Now there's a few different types of TP4056 charging modules. This one has separate battery and output pins. I made the mistake in my last video of bridging them, but it actually cuts off the power when the battery goes down to 2.5 volts, so it's best practice to take advantage of that feature and prevent flattening your battery. Next we have an AMS1117 DC-DC step-down module. These come in various voltages from 1.2 to 5 volts. This one here is 2.5 volts. I'm not sure if it will work at this stage, but let's see. Time to insert the battery blank. This was the first revision, so it was more difficult to get the wires through. Next, I 3D print a housing which I'll glue on with B7000. B7000 is removable with heat, one of the most versatile glues available. We'll glue on the battery also. After soldering on the wires, let's see if it works. No, it does not. Perhaps the trackpad won't operate at 2.5 volts. let's swap out the regulator for a 3.3 volt version. Still no go, something isn't right. I suspected the first revision of the battery blank wasn't making contact, so I added a nub and also put a channel down the side to make it easier to get the wires in. And what I should have done before, tested the connection with the ohms meter. With that out of the way, I can solder the wires back on. And it works, yes. It's functioning normally. This is after a few days of use. The battery is still at 3.8 volts, down from 4.2 volts. Now I'm not sure if the 2.5 volt regulator would have worked. It may have been a better option for battery longevity. There is also a 2.8 volt version if you can find that. There's also an adjustable one you can set at 3 volts using two resistors. According to this data sheet, the regulator should not work with the input voltage that I'm supplying it, but as you can see, it is working quite okay. Disadvantages over using AAs. The Mac won't display a low battery warning. I haven't had it go flat yet, but I assume it will just cut off. This isn't a problem because a USB charge cable can be plugged in while in use. If you're doing one of these or any other dual AA battery to LiPo conversion, it's probably best to try a 2.5 volt regulator first and stick with that if it works. That's it for this video. It's been 5 days since I last charged the trackpad, still isn't flat. I'll add a note in the description of the charge time. Make sure to like and subscribe. Also check any links in the description. And hang on to those old phone batteries, you never know where you can use them. Thanks for watching.